This is going to be one of the best podcasts we've ever done. We're going to have some fun. And I'm surprising Mikey Foon. We're going to do something completely unexpected to the guy. He thinks we're doing a Zoom podcast, a pile of scrap, and I'm just so excited about this. But we're going to do it in person. Never been to Admiral Metals. And he has no idea I'm here in Detroit. Here to see Mike?
Yeah, I know Joe.
That's his brother.
Oh, this is so good. Wait till you see this. He's going to freak. How about doing the podcast in person?
Having my wife like, where should I put the camera? Where should I do this? I'm doing a Zoom call. This is amazing. Super unexpected. Super excited. Like, he told me it was a Zoom call.
He looked at me and go, I know you.
Now I gotta find like a real spot that we can do this in.
This the old school vibe.
It's what it is, Mike.
Sorry, your name?
Elliot.
Elliot.
I run the Admiral Metals one.
He likes to keep our separated.
I'm the Kim Kardashian, you know, I can't ruin that.
He wants to be at Mikey Foon and Mikey Foon only.
But he doesn't, Mikey Foon, I haven't seen Mikey Foon out there.
We'll get into that.
I can't believe you're here. It's so amazing.
Well, let me do the intro first.
Oh, well.
I guess you can do it for me.
No, you're on.
No, you, what are we doing? What are we filming?
This is Pile of Scrap.
Awesome, Mikey.
The following is an original audio series from Sierra International Machinery, Pile of Scrap, with your host, Mikey Foon. Say what?
I'm here in Detroit, well, Sterling Heights.
Close
Detroit,
enough.
We're in Motown.
Yeah.
The Motor City. Surprise visit.
Oh my God, pumped. I'm telling you for real. You told me it was going to be a Zoom call.
Right.
I was ready. I was, you know, putting the camera, where's it going to be, FaceTiming my wife, making sure it was a good angle, and then all of a sudden, the power goes out.
Where's the offer?
Yeah, it did. We walked in. As soon as we walked in, there was
a power surge and a pier. John Sacco. It was pretty amazing. Godly.
I'm so happy you're here so you can get a look around and explain
this
things.
This is such an old school scrapyard office.
Man, it's just like I haven't been in one in a while.
Everyone's getting with the times except for us.
This is so much fun. You know, Pile of Scrap, we're going to talk about this funk that you've been in because of COVID.
Totally.
Well, COVID-19 shut me down from my Pile of Scrap.
So here we are. We're not exactly in Detroit, okay? We're like, what, 20 minutes north? So we're on 18 Mile, 8 Mile. I'm sure you've all seen the movie. If not, you should. It's now in the music, the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow.
This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. Good. This is what I thrive on. This is what
you're so good at.
Well, thank you. It's what I love to do. You know when they say you find something you love, you'll never work a day in your life?
That's this.
This
for you.
This is it for me.
And this is Elliot, by the way, my brother. The little brother.
I'm sure some of you know him.
You influenced me with your social media. Every day Mikey Foon was out there.
A go bike. 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 A go bike.
And when I met you...
Well, let's talk about that really quick. I don't mean to cut you off. Who would have thought that when I met you at the ISRI convention...
So you're not an actual customer, but you followed Sierra on the social media and seen kind of in the pack.
And I came up to you and I was this wild, rambunctious, little crazy lunatic who wanted to do something that was way out of your comfort zone.
Thank you. down, which is fair.
Love you guys. Love your equipment. You guys do a fantastic job of promoting it. You have beautiful stuff. I think it's probably the best in the industry. Really, you guys are in front of the pack on how you guys promote yourselves. You guys have the best videos. You guys have the best people that you talk to with great information. I think that you guys are setting the bar for all of it.
And Darren, who films and does this for me, said to me, hey, look, Mikey's got 10,000 people following him.
I wish. Not that many.
But it was, I don't remember the number, but it was staggering. And I'm like, we need to do this.
Where do you say the scale is?
Oh, that way.
You can see in ground. You can see somebody's coming on right now. We used to have like when you go to the deli counter and you pull a number. To have like one of those, but with social distancing and trying to keep down touching things, we now just have people going.
Let's get into something important in respect to this. You've gone silent and you shared with me this is a little tough time for you. Talk to me.
I'm an emotional person, and you know, maybe that's to my credit of why it's so fun what I do, and I make kind of a comedy out of it. You know, I'm sad about where we are in the world.
Comedy takes, so you're kind of down because you're not finding anything funny in today's world.
Correct.
One of the things is people always get into, I'll be happy when COVID-19's out. I'll be happy when I get this contract. I'll be happy when this is done. I'll be happy. So you have to wait to be happy?
Right.
And you're a happy guy. But, you know, emotional. So, you know, to your credit, Mikey, you know, I can feel it. You know, that I know about you. And you're going to stay positive. You got to stay positive and move forward. Funny story, we're in this, I mean, this is so old-fashioned scrap yard, man.
This is built in like the 50s, I think.
So you guys are a two-man show in an area where you're surrounded by just giants.
Some monsters.
Just giants of the industry.
Yes.
In our region, there is a ton of guys that are doing siding on houses, building, whatnot. So we actually have a bay here dedicated. Guys are dumping siding in here nonstop.
You're your great-grandfather right now.
Yeah.
You and your brother are that original, because you still, even though you're starting what you had something, you guys are having to build it. You're fighting.
This industry makes me excited every day. You know, I really love what I do. I really do. I love making deals. I love meeting people. I love going to these factories, plants, and seeing what they're making, the machines they're using. I love all of that. So, fourth generation, long history of scrapping here in the Detroit area. I don't know exactly when my great grandfather started, but it started so long ago that he was on a horse and buggy that he rented for $1 a day. My dad loves to tell the story that the horse that he rented one day died at the corner of an intersection, and he got a ticket from a police officer because he was impeding traffic. And my great-grandfather was like, sir, I can't move the horse, it died.
So when people come in and they dump stuff, whether it's in steel, aluminum, then they'll park over here to come in and get their payment if it's just steel, or then they'll have their non-ferrous. They'll grab a cart, one of these Home Depot carts, put all their non-ferrous on it, and pull this.
So, the story goes, my dad and grandfather were on a truck together, and then 20 years ago, well, this is the 21st year, 2019, we celebrate our 20th year here at Admiral. So, before that, my dad was only on a truck. He was just a peddler. He had some accounts he would pick up from every day, every week, and just sell to the scrapyards. So 20 years ago, my dad was like, I can do this. Why can't I go
put my stake in the ground, and people bring me scrap.
Fire!
So, non-ferrous, people will come in, go onto the non-ferrous scale here, get their ticket, cash out at the ATM machine. This is where we do the, I don't know what the word is, I'm at a loss for words, but this is where we gather all the non-ferrous that either needs to be processed a little bit further or
this is where all your metals, your red metals, or you buy all your copper, brass, yeah, is in here.
Everything. Batteries, electric motors, you know, anything non-ferrous.
So
unloading.
Was Admiral Metals what your dad started?
Or my dad.
Okay,
yes.
And so would I be correct in saying the A was so you'd be early in the Yellow Pages?
100%.
Can you imagine there's no Yellow Pages today?
Amazing, right?
Yeah.
John, we've been here for 20 years.
Did you go to college?
I did. I went to Michigan State University, graduated, and then I moved to Chicago.
We sort and separate so many things here. Sometimes it's exhausting, but the value of some of these things,
it was worth the sort.
Right.
And I ended up in the third party logistics company.
Okay.
And I was, you know, routing freight, brokering freight. And I was just like, you know, I could do this and make money. I could do something else, great, whatever. But my dad has a business.
You know, from all the little plants that are in the area, there's so many prototype manufacturing. You know, if you're not able to give them a price on Inco 625, they're going to call the other guy. And if they find somebody that can handle the little stuff too, and they're good and competitive on it, and it's not me, then they'll take all the other bulk there too, and then we'll lose out on all of it.
Just a light bulb went off and was like, you know, I could really do something and help the business. I'm moving home.
You're the story, you're the prototypical story of the young brothers. Now it's your turn, it's your generation. And what are you gonna do with it? Are you gonna be a peddler, junkyard, or are you gonna be a metal recycler, a metal processor? Are you gonna be creating your own destiny and going to your own mills direct?
You know, look, so many people do not realize that nothing gets made in this country without recycling,
totally.
If you're gonna bust your ass as hard as you do it, you might as well try to make as much money doing it.
You're absolutely right. You think those auto plants, how much scrap comes from, what's it? Scrap aluminum, steel, it's made back into new vehicles.
Right.
How about all the paper products? You know, I deal in paper, you guys don't, but I deal in cardboard, packaging products, tissue paper, you know, and without us, without this industry,
we wouldn't have any more trees, we wouldn't breathe, we'd be dead. Right?
You know, I've got a gazillion photos that I've posted. How many days have you seen on our post? Beautiful copper bell.
Yeah, love it.
The red one, red.
How many heart emojis have I added to that?
Oh, a lot.
Sexy. I say it every podcast. There's scrap recycling, paper, plastic, metals. We are the original environmentalists.
I love scrap. I love when I make a deal. I love when I can go to a plant and land a new account.
He loves the hum of the Davenport. Because we have been
taking the stuff that would have went to a landfill and repurposing it.
Absolutely. It's not waste. Scrap is not waste because it's a commodity.
Right.
How about that thick piece of rod right there? You put that through your baler? You're a comedian now, right?
So if it has value, how can it be waste?
Agreed.
That's the craziest thing I've seen in a while.
You know, the sinks, this big thing here, obviously not that, because you don't want to shear it, right?
Well, you want to keep it below the blades, guys, because right. In the end, shearing with stainless destroys the blade. So you want to keep it below the knife.
So, you know, that's part of what Pile of Scrap is. Let's get that message out, Mikey. Let's keep it up. And it's incumbent upon you and your community to let that message, and you've done it. I want you to be back out there on your social media.
I will.
Talking about the essential of what it is we're doing. How taking a product, a byproduct from manufacturing, packaging it, and get it back to the melters, put it back into U.S. manufacturing, what we do.
I love you guys, but 550 is what you need. The Rev 1, yeah, I know you love it, but the 550, not. The 550 Shear Baylor Lager is what you need, guys.
Let's just get both. Why don't you?
Why not?
Without us, they can't use the scrap metal.
Yeah.
They just can't. We have to process it so that they can reuse it.
Absolutely. So they can, you know, the repurposing is well said.
So that's pretty much our whole facility. We're almost back where we started. Just enough space to make a living.
Look, Mikey, you know what? This is so awesome. It's so much fun to be
this
here.
This has been a long time coming.
And you didn't see this one coming. This is a haymaker for the community.
I'm telling you,
it.
I thought it was going to be a Zoom call. This is so much better.
Isn't it? Oh, see, for me, this fires me up. This is what I love doing. I love the interaction with people. And you know what? I thank you. Thank you and your brother both for hosting. You know, I just met your brother for the first time today.
I can't believe that, but it makes sense. You would have met him in Israel.
Yeah, but
we were both going to be there.
But it was, yeah, but you. So, you know what? Thank you. Thank you for spending the time with me today, touring your yard. Thank you for what you do and who you are, the kind of person you are.
Thank you.
So, I'm going to close it out. This has been another episode of
Pile of Scrap.
My man! 'Kay, so you guys are Spartans, you're not Wolverines?
Correct.
Or you just couldn't get into Michigan? I mean, let's be honest, because that's a brutal...
Of course I couldn't get in. Come on.
No,
that's why I'm in the scrap business, I'm not an investment banker.